What do you guys know about young Keo? The kid that produced the beat. You guys know anything about this kid?
I know nothing about him.
All right, let me school you really quick. Also, just to let you know, Old Town Road broke the streaming record for a week in America, 143 million streams. Do you know who held the previous record? Do you have any guess?
Held the previous record?
Madonna or
no, I would guess like...
It's a newer artist. Oh, obviously, newer, streaming's okay. New.
Yeah.
Think the guy that's just crushed everything the past decade. He's had more hits than anybody. He's been on the charts more than anybody. He's been on the radio more than anybody. He's crushed everything.
See, what I was going to say, I was actually going to say Sam Smith.
Is it that one young...
It's like you don't even have to finish, JJ. Drake, guys.
Ah, Drake.
Oh, really?
Drake. 116 million for In My Feelings. That was the streaming record.
Is that the Kiki?
I guess God's Plan was Kiki. Pretty huge,
Do You Love Me?
Do You Love Me?
Are You Riding?
I should have thought. Damn. What about Hotline Bling? How did that one do? That one had to do pretty well.
I don't know. I don't have the charts. I don't have the charts like pulled up. But this guy, Young Keo, that produced this, he's a 19-year-old born in the Netherlands. Dude, he started making beats mid-2016 when he got FL Studio. He said he became pretty good pretty fast.
Fruity Loop.
Started selling beats for $20 each on YouTube, selling a lease to the beat. So this is how I used to sell beats in college as well. So for anyone that's not educated, let me put you guys up on game. So when you're a producer and you start selling beats, I used to use a thing called SoundClick back in the day. Not SoundCloud, SoundClick. I don't even know if SoundClick's still around, man. This is a long time ago, 06. Mm-hmm. So this is the same way I started making beats or making money selling beats. I would sell to cats locally, but I would also sell to cats on the internet. And basically what you do is you'd make a beat, you'd put it up on your beat store. For him, he just put it up on YouTube. You'll put a lease option and you'll put a exclusive option. So if they pay for the beat exclusively, they pay me $200, I'll sell them the beat exclusive. It's their beat.
I won't sell it
to anyone again. If they lease it, they're paying me $20. I can sell as many of those $20 leases to anyone else as I want. If they want to buy it exclusively, they can, but they don't have exclusive rights to that song for $20. They can use it on a mixtape. They can use it for whatever. But if anything goes big, I still have all the rights to the beat.
Right.
Makes sense. And sure. I can also still sell it to other people if I want to.
What about royalties in that? Are there royalty issues with either or?
It's more for mixtape shit.
Gotcha.
Because if you put out an album, put out something on iTunes and something goes big, I still own the rights to that.
Gotcha.
So technically I could come back at you with contracts.
Sure.
But so that's how I would do my beats. And this gentleman did something similar. He was just putting his beats on YouTube for $20 a piece. And he would just put an email in the description. They'd email him and he'd send him the beat. Mm. So he was just kind of doing a little hustle there. He said he didn't have any money at the time. So he saved up his lease money until he got $180 to buy a BeatStars membership. BeatStars is like the modern day SoundClick, it sounds like. Okay. BeatStars is like a thing where you can go on there, buy beats, meet other producers. It's like its own social media for producers. You can follow producers, follow people, get notifications when they drop new beats.
$180 to get in though? Jeez.
$180 for the year.
Oh,
so that's what the price is to have a year's worth of membership on BeatStars.
Okay.
So he said he bought the BeatStars joint. What do you know about this? And I'm reading this article on Forbes about this kid. Okay. I was reading this yesterday and it just intrigued me because did you know the Old Town Road features a sample? I figured maybe the guitar was sampled from somewhere, but do you know who he sampled? This kid, 19 years old, young Keo from the Netherlands, Netherlands born. You know who he sampled?
No.
I pulled it up right here. Dude, Nine Inch Nails.
Really?
Trent Reznor. This joint right here. Look at it. There it is, dude. This is the Nine Nails track. It's called Ghosts 4-34.
Huh.
There it is. That's the sample, bud.
Crazy.
Nine Inch Mother Nails.
Wow.
Are you kidding me right now?
The Trent Reznor special.
Literally just added 808s dropped in over this.
Does Nine Inch Nails get money for this?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. Trent's getting paid off that song for sure. Because he had to clear this sample. This couldn't have been huge
without
Trent Reznor saying, I'm going to let this be huge.
Totally.
Or whoever owns it. I don't even know if Trent owns it. Maybe it's Jimmy Iovine and Interscope.
Maybe it's Interscope that still owns it. Yeah.
Somebody had to clear this sample.
Yeah.
Dude. What's crazy about this? We're a minute and two into the song, and there has not been one lyric.
Are there any lyrics to this song? Or is
I have no idea, dude. Look up Nine Inch Nails Ghosts 4-34.
Wow, that's crazy.
How cool is that, though, dude? That's where the sample came from.
Hmm.
So he sampled that joint. The person asked him, the song took off very quickly. So how did the business side work out? Sometimes with a beat, to a popular song that was leased online, the producer doesn't always get compensated properly in the long run. Were you worried that you weren't going to get proper compensation or that you were going to miss out on your share? He said Lil Nas X purchased the most basic beat lease, so contractually, he could only sell 3,000 copies and would have to extend the agreement if he wanted to sell more copies. So that's the terms he had in his lease. I didn't have my contracts that tight at the time. I had some figures, but I couldn't even tell you what they were. He said, I found the song only 10 days after it dropped. So I contacted him and was like, yo, I like the song. Send me the cover art. I want to promote it. We had a good relationship. The song started doing better. And I recognized that it already sold more copies than it should have from the BeatStars lease.
Uh-oh.
We were really close though. So he also told me, yo, bro, if this ever gets big, you're coming with me. When the song started getting big, he said, since we only have lease agreements, we need another one because it's a whole new situation. He came up with another agreement. I got my team. He got his team. And we figured it all out. And right now, everything is perfect.
Wow.
How cool, dude.
Good, good.
Two young cats, both getting money, a ton of money.
Yeah.
Working together. Their first shot at stardom, both of them. And neither of them are like cutting each other's heads off or getting real. Like, that's super sick.
And now,
and not only that, the teams behind them aren't going at each other's throats. Cause that's usually, it's the agents and all the bullshit once that gets involved. So I love that. I love to hear that shit, man.
That's cool.
No doubt.
Apparently the song is instrumental. So there are no lyrics.
So that, wow.
Which Trent does a lot of that.
Yeah. So you just straight sampled that joint. I wonder when that song was originally released.
36 freaking songs on this album. Like, what the hell?
Wow. When was it released? Does it say?
2008.
Date? Interesting, dude.
Ghosts 1
Look at your boy X.
36.
Look at your boy X. Lil Nas X found this guy. Dude, how crazy is... Here's what I wonder. If Lil Nas X had this song written and was like, all right, I need to find me
a beat.
Yeah, and the beat is fire. The beat is the thing that makes the song realistically.
Right.
I mean, once you... The chorus is good.
Too.
Yeah, yeah. Obviously, Billy Ray jumping on it is big. Now, that's another story I heard about that is when they first dropped it, it hit the charts on country radio, and they pulled it off country radio, and they were like, no, this is not country. This is not country radio. And Billy Ray heard about that, and that's when he had his people reach out, and he decided to jump on.
Interesting.
Because he thought that was like kind of unfair.
Yeah, so he's
and
like...
Dude, for an old country guy like Billy Ray Cyrus to be like, whoa, whoa, whoa. My man's not getting a fair shake here. Oh, you guys don't want to let him on the charts?
Watch this.
Watch this shit. Boom. He jumps on the joint.
Hold my beer.
Hits the charts. Exactly. That's super cool, dude. Shots for Billy Ray Cyrus on that,
That's tight.
That is so cool of him. I've been cruising through the city with the